Warmer temperatures and melting snow, a sure sign that spring's getting closer. And now is the time to start sowing the seeds for spring. Adam Bachman here with some tips for jump-starting the season. Welcome. Good to have you back here.
Yeah.
This is a perfect time to get going with some seeds.
It's a great time. I actually started my seeds at home just last week. So now is the time.
Well, I'm going to ask you, what have you had the most success with starting early?
My family is most successful with peppers. We've tried tomatoes, just aren't quite successful. And you can buy really nice, you know, already rooted and leafed out tomatoes. So we generally do a lot of peppers at home.
That's great.
Yeah, fun for making salsa.
You brought in some of the things that you need for this. Why don't you walk us through some
of that? So generally speaking, this is exactly what I use. This is a seed starting kit, and it comes with a few different components. You get the bottom tray, which just is going to hold your peat pellets. Mm-hmm. So inside all of these are these very small peat pellets. And once they're saturated, they take up all the water, and the peat is very good at moisture retention, and those pellets grow in size. So they do a great job of holding onto the water, which is great for seeds because they need that constant moisture.
Where do these do best in the home?
So they need bright light. If you don't have a lot of bright light, at least 8 hours during the day, which is tough during this time of year, you're going to want to supplement with light. This is what I do, and now LED technology has made its way to grow light, so there are a lot of great different LED bulbs that can produce.
Oh, I see them right here, so varying ones.
There's varying.
What's the difference in
them? So you can get bulbs that produce different lights in the spectrum, red, blue, and purple, and those will produce different outcomes in the plant. Mm-hmm. But really, generally speaking, for seed starting, you want this broad daylight spectrum.
In your house, where do you have all this?
We have this equipment on my porch, actually. So it gets some indirect light, and we also have some supplemental light as well.
And you see every manner of seed here.
Brought a lot of different varieties of seeds. One of the things that we also like at my house are these seed sprouters. So this is about as close as you can get to instant gratification in the gardening world.
Yeah.
You've maybe had sprouts on a bagel sandwich or something
like
that. So we like to do these as well. You can stack these trays, you set the seeds in there, and you run water over them a few times a day. And then just in a couple days, you have these nice sprouts that are edible. You can do microgreens, even just for a nice fancy garnish on something, or to eat as well. There's a nice smoothie mix in here that's also popular at my house.
Is water obviously an essential ingredient? What do other nutrients you use?
So once your seeds have sprouted and you're ready to do some transplanting, that's when you'd want to get into some different soils, some peat pots, and potentially some fertilizer. But for now, you'd want to stay away from that.
Yeah. And last but not least, if you don't want to do any of that, you can do these beautiful watch
them grow gardens.
Yeah.
So these are our trademark watch them grow gardens, and they're a variety of spring flowering bulbs. So tulips, hyacinth, daffodils, and you can see sort of the different progressions here. Few different sizes. They're great gifts. It's that sure sign of spring coming.
And in just a matter of weeks, you have all this gratification,
That's
which
right.
is just wonderful.
Yeah.
You make me want to go home and start doing some of this. Thank you.
Should.
This
yeah.
is great.
Yeah.
We're almost ready.
Yeah.
We have posted Adam's tips at care11.com. Look under the 4 p.m. show page for details.